thanks for stopping by. Two douches, so it's in less than 7 days. Two turkeys in 1 week, as they say. This is going to be a continuation of the video from a few days ago. If you weren't here, we're going through a baker's dozen of 2022 releases, random assortment that I'm showing, ones I've listened to recently. There's really not a lot of rhyme or reason to it. The last one did have more of a, there's more power or post-punk in there. This time I think we've got some power pop, shoegaze, dream pop. There's even a jazz record. It's a 90s reissue, something that was reissued. I believe it was reissued in 2022. If not, it's completely screwed everything up. I apologize again. I'm really trying, because I stink so bad. I'm trying to like do something about it. Put on some cologne, but that's like, you know, if you put cologne on roadkill, it still stinks like roadkill with cologne on it. Anyway, if you're interested in a beer, this is what I'm having. From La Cumbre Brewing Company, which I've had a number of their beers. Never had this one until just now. It's called Luminosity Hazy IPA. So out of New Mexico. It's not a bad pour. I mean, it's not the best hazy IPA, but it's a long ways away from the worst hazy IPA. They do good work over there in New Mexico. Anyway, I stopped there for a second. Of course, as soon as I started doing this, landscapers, leaf blowers, whatever. So I might have to, I'm just gonna roll with it. I'll pause or whatever. So I'm just gonna do just like last video, show, and a lot of other videos. I'm gonna show a record, say almost nothing, and then move on and do that over and over again. First up, this is the, just noticing that this jacket is warped. Anyway, it's the 13th LP from the band. I think originally from Nova Scotia. I think they're probably in Toronto now. I don't know. It's the band Sloan. Their album called Steady Quartet. It's got this, you know, where you, I don't know if you can see that on the screen, but anyway, you know, Sloan, all four members write, sing, play multiple instruments. It's power pop, extremely consistent for their, you know, 13 albums. This is, again, no exception. Big hooks, last like 70s power pop vibes. It's a bit of country, a bit of glam rock. Probably not gonna win over any new fans, but I think that the fans that they have are going to be happy with this album. I would say I definitely prefer side A over side B. That could change. Things change. So the printed inner sleeve. As the leaf blowers get closer. This is on. It's on purple. I don't know if you know what purple looks like. The writing's on the wall, but the words came slowly. Take a stand from kids. Sure, if you've stepped over to help yourself to a meat stick, I have an orgasmic selection of meat stick for you to choose from. You can, you know, nibble on any of the meat sticks that you can find. I even have turkey. 'Tis the season for turkey meat stick. And if you like gravy, I'm not gonna disappoint you. I've got gravy. I've got gravy to go with that that turkey meat stick. moving right along, this is the this is a band out of Provo or Salt Lake City, I guess. I don't know. I think they're originally from Provo. It's kind of a like pop psych thing called The Melons. The album is called Introducing the Melons. So very much a like 60s bubblegum pop psych thing, a la like Smile era Beach Boys or like Magical Mystery Tour, if you've heard of that. That they kind of, you know, have that those kind of vibes going. It may also scratch like if you've got an Elephant Six scratch that needs itching. Or that's an itch that needs scratching. This might do it. Yeah. The Melons. Introducing the Melons. So, you know, Baroque, chamber pop, twee, certainly, psychedelic. Insert that came with it. I'm having a hard time at this spot. It's on like really yellow vinyl. Anyway, The Melons. I like this more than I thought I would. The first time it was a bit cheesy, but no, it's good. I wanna know it all. Sure what the deal is. It seems like there's a lot of like Canadian artists in this stack. I can't remember if in part one if we had a lot of Canadian. I don't think so. Nexus is a Canadian, I think from Calgary, kind of like a dream pop group. It's their second LP. The group is called Crystal Eyes, and the album is The Sweetness Restored. I'm Bobo Integral? Bobo Integral on that label out of Madrid. It's a lot of varied influences on here, ranging from new wave, shoegaze, like there's like even like some 60s girl group vibes. But you know, dream pop. The album title. First, the band name is Crystal Eyes. That's not a, like it's hard to, there is like a power metal group called Crystal Eyes also, and then there's like an LA Guns song called Crystal Eyes. Anyway, and The Sweetness Restored is a line from Leonard Cohen's final album, You Want It Darker. Anyway, Leaf Blower outside, I'm just gonna keep going. But there are occasional like New Order vibes on here as well. This one's grown on me again. Crystal Eyes, the sweetness restored. I think I said that wrong earlier. Just on Delicious Black Vinyl.
Come for you. Now I know.
next up and I'm just noticing this jacket is all scuffed up. Like, I don't know what the hell is going on. I don't know what's going on with the world. This is like an Irish, Italian slash Irish husband wife duo called Submodal. The album is One Final Summit Before the Fall. It's on Shelf Life in the US. Call this mostly like a dense like a densely textured noise pop slash shoegaze slash post rock or something. The vocals, the female vocals, are mostly, you know, primarily female vocals, but they're mostly buried deep. Like, you cannot, generally speaking, you cannot understand the vocals, which I'm not sure is a problem. It's mastered by Simon Scott of Slow Dive. Anyway, kind of a dreamy, like dreamy pounding wall of sound, kind of like, at times at least, shimmery guitars, you know, it's this is like, I would call this shoegaze all the way. Came out a lot earlier in the year, again on Shelf Life here in the US. The group is out of Indiana. It's a dream pop slash shoegaze type thing. The band is called Whimsical and the album is called Melt. They're from Indiana. I didn't already say, I might have already said that. You can kind of tell the vibe of the artwork. It's very like ethereal female vocals, dreamy shoegaze. There's some electronic elements. Has some Lush, like the band Lush or Velocity Girl, like those kind of vibes. You know, at points, not always. I'm thinking that it's mostly a duo also at this point. They've been around since the late 90s. This is only their fourth LP. The first one on Shelf Life. So the group is called Whimsical, album is Melt. That we don't hear more about like violent like murders happening to people that are blowing leaves. Seems like that's like a lot of people just snap at those leaf blowing people. Next, this is another thing from Canada, the Calgary based improviser slash multi-instrumentalist. I'm gonna say his name wrong. I think it's Jairus Sharif, I believe. And the album is called Water and Tools. It's on Telephone Explosion Records. So this was recommended as like something of a experimental jazz album. I guess you could call it that. It's mostly Sharif. I'm gonna call him Sharif because it's easier for me to say Sharif. And I think that's being said correctly, unlike Jairus, which is a guess. But he plays almost everything on here. There's alto sax, he even does the field recordings that are on here. Flute and bells, keyboards. There's samplers. I think that's him from earlier this year. That's the print in her sleeve. So it is at times like hostile, like almost industrial free jazz, maybe. And then it goes from that to like almost like warmer, more pleasant, I guess, if you want to say ambient. A lot of synths, some subtle like hip hop beats. Like I say, feel like there's birds. I think this plays best as a full album. Just a little snippet. You won't get a sense of really what it's about, I don't think. As an album, it's like you go on a up and down. It takes you on a journey, let's just say. Anyway, if you're into jazz, maybe, even then, I don't know. Jairus Sharif, Water and Tools. Next one, I don't know if I would have, I saw it used, or I don't even know if it would have been on my radar at all. It's on Felt, F-E-L-T-E. The artist is Fashion Club, and the album is called Scrutiny. This is a lot different than, it's a little different than the kind of thing I would normally show on here. I'm gonna read you the hype sticker. Debut art rock album from founding member of Los Angeles's Moaning. For fans of early Brian Eno, Kate LeBond, Wire, Colin Newman, Crank Loud, and Japan, it's like, it's very like gothy almost. The vocals are really like deep. And then it's it's very electronic, like drum machine. Apparently there are actual drums on here, but it seems like it's a lot of drum machine and electronic textures. Really like kind of almost shoegaze or dream pop guitars, but also very electronic. It doesn't really fit into a box, I would say. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. Anyway, it's the inner sleeve. It has words on there. Fashion Club. refill on your gravy, you can, you know, feel free. You don't have to ask. You don't have to ask permission. If you need an additional meat stick to nibble on, you don't have to ask. Just, you know, just do it. This is the last one I think we're showing today. This is a reissue of an album that originally came out in 1996. I believe it's the reissue came out earlier this year. I could be wrong. So it's the fourth LP from the Hershey, Pennsylvania band called The Ocean Blue. The album is called Sea. Sea, the Ocean Blue. So while they're from Hershey, Pennsylvania, they, to me, even in 1996 and in before, in their earlier albums, they sound like they're from Europe. They sound like they're from Glasgow or somewhere in England. So this was originally released on Mercury Records. This reissue is on Corda Records. The story goes, I think this is their last major label release after their first three were also major label albums. This one, I think after they released the first single and it didn't really get any traction, I think that the label really like quickly lost interest, like stopped really supporting them from that point on. It really does seem like they were trying to get like, trying to get some level of traction at radio. There's some very catchy, radio friendly type songs. In 1996, I had this, I liked it. I don't think that I loved it. Listening to it now, like reevaluating it, I definitely have not listened to this probably since at least sometime in the 90s, I would say. And I will say, I feel like I like it more now than I did at the time, but you know, who knows? Yeah, some really good pop tunes. Maybe a little jangly, a little Brit poppy for a Pennsylvania band. I'm not sure how many of these they made or how readily available they are. Corda Records. I'm really not sure. Printer sleeve, words. And I think it's mine is just on delicious black vinyl. The Ocean Blue Sea. Once again, I apologize for my odor. I'm gonna have to just. I really need to do better. You just can't cover it up. You gotta really get in there and clean things up, I guess. Anyway, we'll see you turkeys later. Cheers. This turkey's painful and black. This turkey's painful and black. But I just keep coming back. What kind of magic is that? What kind of magic is that?